Some Iraq war survivors are upset about an upcoming video game that is based on the life or death experiences that they face for real. 6 Days in Fallujah is based on the battle, the second battle of Fallujah in 2004, widely regarded as the U.S.'s toughest urban battle since Vietnam. The companies behind the game say that some people believe video games shouldn't tackle real-life events. To these people, video games seem more like toys than a medium capable of communicating something insightful. We disagree. Throughout history, we've tried to understand our world through events that happened to somebody else. 6 Days in Fallujah asks you to solve these real-life challenges for yourself. We believe that trying to do something for ourselves can help us understand not just what happened, but why it happened the way it did. Video games can connect us in ways other media cannot. Joining me now is an Iraq war survivor, Najla Abdulelah, who is with me. Najla, I know you disagree very much with that statement coming from the games makers. Tell me why you are opposing the release of this video game.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for having me. So I believe this game absolutely gamifies traumatic experiences for profit. It's a very despicable form of exploitation, and it puts people like me not only in danger of facing our past traumas in a very live way, but also with a possible threat of future violence against us when this game is lumping people that look like me as possible insurgents as well as civilians. It's a very damaging way of looking at experiences that happen to real life people. This is very recent history, and the idea of this game being released is just, it's beyond mortifying to me.
Now, to be clear, you were not there during the time of the Battle of Fallujah, but violence from the Iraq War was part of your daily life, right? You were walking alongside your friend on the way to school when your friend was shot.
I grew up in Iraq. I was born and raised there, and I came to the U.S. in 2008. However, I was not there for that specific war. But as you mentioned, I did experience some severely traumatic experiences, one of which was my a friend of mine being shot and paralyzed from the waist down while we were in school. It was just a casual day, and we all had to go back to class after it. There was no time to digest what happened. There was no time to understand what had just taken place, no time to even understand the trauma. You just had to continue on. And this game will merely open up these wounds in such a way that is just absolutely absurd. No Iraqi has been consulted, to my knowledge, about this game. And if there were enough people consulted, this game would not be coming about.
The makers of this game say that they did consult, I believe, with Iraqis, and they collaborated. Here, let me tell you what they say. They say that they collaborated with more than 100 service members who were there during the Battle of Fallujah, and they interviewed dozens of Iraqis, a number of them from Fallujah. And they're trying to make a case that this is a chance for people to learn. But you don't see it that way. I know you have concerns about what this will mean for how people view Muslims. What are your fears?
Like I mentioned, if you know, a larger sample would have to be tested for this kind of game. A couple of dozen people do not represent 20 million people that have suffered through the traumas of the Iraq War. The Iraq War as a whole has a lot more to it than just the opinion of a mere two dozen people. I do think Islamophobia, while it's on the rise, will also be impacted severely with this game. It'll paint my face as a possible insurgent, as a possible civilian. You'll never look at one person and assume they're either or. It'll add that layer of this is a possible threat. And that is mortifying to me. That is very scary.
In this particular game, and look, I watched the trailer for it. It seems incredibly realistic. But they say that gamers can choose between being a U.S. serviceman who's leading a team on missions against insurgents. And in the trailer, that is very much the role that is emphasized. There's also an option to be an unarmed Iraqi father who's trying to escape with his family to safety. And players hear narratives from real people. I mean, what do you think, in the end, the gamers who participate in this game will be looking for?
I'm not sure exactly what they would be looking for, but this to me just screams exploitation of trauma. I mean, it's just, I can't even begin to think why anybody would want to play that game, let alone to, you know, for it to be made. It's just, it baffles me, honestly. I don't understand why anybody would want to play it. I strongly urge the makers to shelf the game. And if they do end up putting it out, then I strongly urge the public to not buy it, to not partake.
Najla, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Thank you for having me.